Hello guys, some of you were asking me about Yodo1 integration process for Android and iOS. So today in this video I'm gonna show you how I do it for my project, for my current game, which is Endurance. And I hope this video is gonna help you to solve all of the problems that you have. And by the way, right now I'm using Apple Deal for ads mediation for Android. I just wanted to test it, just to see what are the pros and cons of Apple Deal in comparison to Yodo1, because some of you were asking me why I'm using Yodo1 SDK instead of Apple Deal. And I've decided actually just to give it a try, and I'm going to share results in the next video, but today I'm going to show you how to integrate a Yodo1 SDK in your project. So let's start. So you can go directly to this page, supportyodo1.com, and then you can go to the Unity. You can choose Unity integration if you're using Unity. That's what I'm going to show you today. So I'm going to use Unity integration. So just press here, and let's scroll down a bit. And okay, so here's the plugin, standard mass plugin. So I'm going to download this version for now. Yes, I am. So let's import the Unity package that we just downloaded, and let's go to import package, custom package, and let's import it here. So it's going to import external dependency manager, plugins, Unity Bridge for iOS, Yodo1 folder, and let's import. Let's go back to the document for implementation and let's see what it says. So we've done, by the way, I'm using Unity 2020.3. So I'm using Firebase as well, so I've updated Firebase, that's for sure. That's important, I guess, so please do that. After that, let's continue going down. Fourth step is enter application information. So let's go to assets. Go to assets, mass settings, Android settings, and here you have to enter your app details. So remember, when you get into your profile in the Yodo1, if you registered already with the Yodo1, you got your mass app key and you got AdMob app ID that you have to use here. So don't forget about that. I'm going to just stop the video and I'm just going to enter my details. And you have to do it for Android and for iOS as well. And then I'm going to continue recording the video. All right, guys, I just have done that. So let's continue. So the next step, we have to go to the assets, Android Resolver. Let's go to assets, Android Resolver, settings. And here we have to check this use Jetifier. So if you just scroll down here, it's already checked here. So probably for most of you, it's going to be checked already, so but just don't forget to check it out. After that, you press OK and let's go to the next step. The next thing, what I'm doing normally, I'm just to Android Resolver and I press Force Resolve. Alright guys, so it has finished. Alright guys, so the next step is basically coding part. So I'm gonna show you my example how I've implemented this in my game. So I've got, I've created a Yodo script. Basically it handles all of the interstitial, rewarded, banner ads in the game. And so functions from this script are called from other from other scripts within the game. So for instance, when player dies, he gets a message if he wants to revive a character within that, and then he presses the button, and then from this script, function of reviving character within that gets called, and then player revives his character. So let's scroll down a bit. The first thing you need to add, very important, is using this library, using Yodo1 Mass. And then I'm using here singleton pattern. So the object, this object that I'm having, I'm actually having this object right here. So it's right now it's inactive. I'm going to explain it later on, a little bit later on why it's inactive. But it's in the main scene. So this is the main the very first scene, the main menu. And I've got this object Yodo, and it has only one script, Yodo script. So let's continue. So we have to on the start in the start method, we have to initialize Yodo SDK. It gets initialized here. Then we have to initialize callbacks for interstitial rewarded and banner ads. This function, don't bother about that one. This is just I've created, so I'm just gonna show you later on what it does. I'm just gonna close it for now. And this is where we're actually setting interstitial ads callbacks. So I'm just gonna uncomment this one. And this is the one here. Then we get show interstitial ads. So this function I'm calling in between the levels from the script. So I'm just gonna uncomment this one as well. Then we're getting here, which is callbacks for the rewarded videos. Let's just uncomment this one as well. And here you go. Remember, I was telling you about rewards that I'm getting given to players. So in the very last part here, in the add reward, all these functions you can get from the Yodo1 SDK example. So I just copied it and just changed them a little bit so they fit my game. So yeah, let's scroll down here, and then here in the very last case, add reward. So I'm calling this function, which I actually have here. So this function basically gets the reward to the player. So it just has different cases for many different rewards that I've got in that game. But this is where you have to implement your rewards. Yeah. So here is just here in set reward that video adds callback. So after that, we have to uncomment this one as well, which is show rewarded video ads. So this function gets called when player sees the window asking him if he wants to get some reward, and this function is getting called, and on its callback he gets the reward after the ad was showed, you know. So after that I've got this banner ad as well. So all these functions, this one as well, this is a banner callback, all it's here. So banner callback. Yep, so everything is here, and this is the banner ad. It actually gets shown in the menu start, and this is to hide the banner. So all these functions, as I said, you can get in the or in here, or you can just get them in the Yodo1 example project. That's it basically. So you've got all these things happening here. Don't bother about this stuff. This is just like for the rewards. I just created many different bulls for rewards that I've got in my game, but basically that's it. So you're just on the start, you're just initializing SDK, you just set in the callbacks, and then you're using interstitial function main, like as a main one, and then you show reward that video ads, and that's it. And after that, and right now I'm going to explain you how to implement GDPR consent and how to implement COPPA consent as well. If your game is targeting audience younger than 13 years old, and this is for COPPA and GDPR, if you're publishing your game globally. So let's get back to the scene, and I'm just gonna show you what happens when I just first start my scene. And pay attention to this inactive Yodo1 object. So let's start the scene. So when the player starts the game for the very first time, he gets this message and it's asking him to read the privacy policy and to agree with it or to disagree with it if he presses this button. And as you can see here in the global object, yeah, so the Yodo1 object is still inactive. Why I'm actually having this like that, so because I don't want to initialize Yodo1 SDK when the game just started. So it has to be initialized a little bit later on when the player to consent or not to consent to all of the questions, which is GDPR and COPPA. So only after that, Yodo1 SDK has to be initialized. So before that, we have to get all of the responses from player. If he's agreeing with the GDPR, if he is agreeing with COPPA. So when the player press this agree button or this disagree button, so I'm going to show you what happened, what's on those buttons. So I've got another script here, which is basically menu screen. And if you go to... to this function. So this function is getting called when the player presses agree button. And as you can see here, if he agrees, just don't bother about the rest of the, those are just animations and music, but the most important thing is this one. So Yodo1 sets GDPR to true value. And the same thing happens with if player doesn't agree with the privacy policy, so it sets the GDPR to false. So after that, we get another window, which basically is a COPPA. So my game is targeting players younger than 13 years old. So that's why I have to implement these things or COPPA. So when the player presses continue button, yeah, that's what you can see. It happens here, so it's checking the age, and this is the most important part, just don't bother about the rest. So if the user is older than 13, then the Yodo1 sets COPPA to false, and opposite, if it's younger, if he's younger, then it sets COPPA to true value. And also what happens there, I am activating Yodo1 game object, so it gets activated right here. So only after we got all of the responses from the player, then we are activating initializing Yodo SDK. We're activating this object, yeah, and then the Yodo1 function is starting and it's initializing SDK only after we got all of the responses from the player. So remember that's very important. And basically that's it. Then you can just continue and you just can start the game. And after that, all of the things are initialized. But this is actually what happens in the very first time. After that, for the second, third, and so on times, player doesn't get those questions. So that's what happens here. So we are activating this Yodo1 object, this one, with the C# script Yodo on the start of the game. So we have to only for the first time before player give us all of the consents, we have to wait before we are initializing Yodo1 SDK. But for the rest of the times, we can just activate Yodo1 SDK right away on the start of the game. So just keep that in mind. And one more thing, actually, I almost forgot to tell you. So here in the top, if you're using everywhere we're using these kind of functions like set GDPR or value or set COPP value, yes, you have to add this library in top. So basically that's it. And I'm just gonna build the project right now. And I hope this video helped you a little bit to understand how to implement Yodo1 SDK. And actually, you can just simply download Yodo1 example project on their website. And it seems pretty clear to me. So just do that if it's still unclear for you what I've just explained. And thank you very much for watching me. And in the next video, I'm going to talk a bit about the revenue, because it kind of dropped a lot since January. And also I'm going to tell you about my experiments with Apple Deal, and I'm going to compare them with Yodo1. So going to be pretty interesting, I guess, for many of you. And yep, thanks for subscribing. I really appreciate that. The channel is growing slowly, and that's pretty cool. Thanks, guys. Have a good one.